हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आज हम पढ़ेंगे वोटर। वोटर, सपोज फॉर सम रीजन योर फैमिली गेट्स ओनली वन बकेट ऑफ वाटर एवरी डे फॉर ए वीक, व्हाट वुड हैपन? वुड यू एबल टू कुक, क्लीन अटेंसिल, वॉश क्लॉथ और बाथ? अपार्ट फ्रॉम ड्रिंकिंग, देयर आर सो मेनी एक्टिविटीज फॉर विच वी यूज वॉटर। डू यू हैव एन आइडिया अबाउट द क्वान्टिटी ऑफ वाटर वी यूज इन ए सिंगल डे? You know, have a rough idea as to how much water your family uses in a day. Using this information, calculate the amount of water needed by your family in a year. अब you have listened a number of activities for which you use water. Do you think our water requirement is limited to activities like these? We use wheat, rice, pulses, vegetable, many other foods for item every day. So we need water not only for our daily activities but also for producing many things. Where do we get water from? We get water from some way. We draw water from a river, spring, ponds. Some other mates say we get water from taps. Have you ever wondered where water in the taps come from? Water that we get from tap is also drawn from a lake or river or whole earth. Each of us may be getting water into our homes in different way. We have discussed some of the sources of water. Just like ponds, lake, river, wells, aati. Do you know that about 2/3 of earth is covered with water? Most of this water is in ocean and sea. The water in the ocean and sea has many salt dissolvents. A famous writer say, water, water everywhere, nor any drop to drink. Means, पानी सब जगह है पर पीने के लिए पानी नहीं है, पानी कहीं भी नहीं है। Here the poet has described to the plight of sailors on the ship lost in the ocean. Yet ocean play an important role in supplying the water that we use. Does the water supply in these places also depend on the ocean? How does the ocean water reach ponds, lake, river, bowls? How come the water from these sources not saline any more? That is where the water cycle comes in. Our water cycle. How many times have you noticed the water spilled on the floor, dry up after some time, dry wetter cloth as they dry up? Water from wheat, wet roads, rooftop are disappear after some time. What did we find? The water evaporated and the salt was left behind. This activity gives us an idea that on heating water change into the vapor. We also realize from this activity that water vapor does not carry away the salt with it. Water vapor so found became a part of the air and cannot usually be seen. We also found that heating is essential to convert water into its vapor. We have seen that water change into a vapor also from the field, road, rooftop. अब हम एक प्रैक्टिकल करते हैं, एक एक्टिविटी करते हैं। Take two similar plate, place one of plate in sunlight and keep the other plate under shade. Now pour equal water. You can use a cap or bottle of measured water. Make sure. Observe the two plates after every 15 minutes. Does the water seem aim to disappear from which plate? During the daytime, sunlight falls the water in oceans, river, lake and pond. The field and the other lands area also receive sunlight. As a result, our water from all these places continually change into vapor. Did you find that water also disappeared from the plate kept in under shade? Though it was had taken more time, does the heat from the sunlight reach here? Yes, during the daytime, all the air surrounding us gets heated. The warm air provides heat for evaporation of water in the shade. Thus, evaporation takes place from all open surface of water. As a result, water vapor gets continuously added to the air. However, evaporation of water is a slow process. Means in sunlight, evaporation takes place faster. On heating water in a burn, it evaporation takes place even faster. About loss of water by plants. You have learned in chapter that plants need water to grow. Plants use a part of the water to prepare the food and retain some of in their different parts. Remaining water of the body is released by the plants into air as water vapor through the process of transpiration. Abey, water vapor enters the air through the process of evaporation and transpiration. Ab how are clouds form? Take a glass half filled with water. Whip the glass from the outside with a clean piece of cloth. Add some ice into the water. Wait for 1 to 2 minutes. Observe the change take the place on the outer surface of the glass. From where do your water drop appear on the other side of the glass? The cold surface of the glass containing iced water cools the air around it, and the water vapor of the air condensation on the surface of the glass. The process of condensation play an important role in bringing water back to the surface of the earth. A bit get cool. We go higher from the surface of the earth. It get cooler when the air move up. It get cooler and cooler at sufficient height. The air becomes so cool that the water vapor present in condensation so form teeny drops of water called droplets. It is these teeny droplets that remain floating in air and appear to us as cloud. It so happened that many droplets of water come together to form larger sized drop of water. Some of drop water become so heavy that they begin to fall. These falling water drop are what we call rain. In special condition, it may also fall as hail or snow. Back to the ocean. पानी जो है जल जो है वाटर जो है वो वापस ओशन में कैसे जाता है. What happened to the water that rain and snow bring to different region of the earth? Almost all land surface are above the level of oceans. Most of the water that falls on the land and rain and snow sooner or later goes back to the ocean. Of this water flow down to the mountain in the form of stream and river. Some of water that falls on land as rain also flow on the, from the river and stream. Most of the river cover long distance on land and ultimately fall into sea and ocean. Of the rain water also fills up the lakes and pond. A part of the rain water gets absorbed by the ground and seem disappear in the soil. Most of this water became available to us as groundwater. Open wells are fed by groundwater. Groundwater is the source for many lakes as well. It is also this groundwater which is drawn by a hand pump and a tube. Rainwater flow away quickly. Flowing rainwater also take the top layer of the soil away with it. There are few areas where most of the land is covered with concrete. This reduces the seepage of rainwater into the ground, which ultimately affect the availability of groundwater. We now know that water brought back to the surface of the earth by rain, hail, or snow goes back to ocean. Thus, water from the ocean and surface of the earth goes into air as vapor, return as rain. Finally goes back to ocean. The circulation of water in the manner is known as water cycle. This circulation of water between ocean and land is the continuous process. This maintains the supply of water over land. What if it rain heavily? The time duration, the amount rainfall varies from place to place. In some parts of the world, it rain throughout the year, while there are places where it rain only for a few days. In our country, most of the rainfall occurs during the monsoon season. Rain brings relief, especially after hot summer day. The sowing of many crops depend on the arrival of monsoon. Heavy rains may lead to the rise in the level of water in river, lakes and ponds. The water may then spread over large area, causing flood. The crop field, forest, village and cattle may get submerged by water. What happens if it does not rain for a long period? Can you imagine what would happen if it does not rain in a region for a year or more? The soil continues to lose water by evaporation and transpiration. It is not being brought back by rain. The soil becomes dry. The level of water in pond and of the region goes down, and some of them may even dry up. The groundwater may also become scarce. This may lead to drought. In drought condition, it is difficult to get food and fodder. How can we conserve water? Only a small fraction of water available on the earth is fit for use of plants, animals and humans. Most of the water is in the oceans and it cannot be used directly. When the level of groundwater decreased drastically, this cannot be used anymore. The total amount of water on earth remains the same, but the water available for use is very limited. It is decreasing with over usage. The demand for water is increasing day by day. The number of people using water is increasing with rising population in many cities. Long queues for collection of water is a common sight. To shortage of water in many parts of the world, hence it is very important the water is used carefully. अब rainwater harvesting क्या है कि one way of increasing the availability of water is to collect rainwater and store it for later use. Collecting rainwater in this way is called rainwater harvesting. Means catch water where it falls. इसके लिए two procedure. Here two techniques of rainwater harvesting are discussed. Rooftop rainwater harvesting. In this system, the rainwater is collected from the rooftop to a storage tank through pipe. This water may contain soil from the roof and need filtering before it is used. Instead of collecting rainwater in the tank, the pipes can go directly into a pit in the ground. This then can seep into the soil to recharge or refill the groundwater. Another option is to allow water to go into the ground directly from the roadside drain that collect rainwater. The amount of usable water on earth is limited, so it need to be used carefully. Thank you.